Hey everyone, Nick here again, and this is video number 3 in my series about how I analyze zip codes from a list. So maybe you work for a museum, zoo, aquarium, and you are asking your visitors where they're coming from. You're asking them for zip codes, and at the end of the year, you have thousands of zip codes that you need to analyze, and I'm showing you some ways that you can get some great information from them for free using Excel, the software you probably already have access to and work with almost every day. You don't need anything fancy for this, just Microsoft Excel. If you haven't downloaded the United States Zip Code Database from unitedstateszipcodes.org, please go ahead to that website and download their free database. We also have a video that I'll link to above for downloading that video too. That was the first video in our series. Okay, so I'm back here to my list of zip codes here. Remember, I have 30 zip codes in my list, 1 through 30. We've already set up our tabs, our columns for our XLOOKUP for our city, county, and state. That's the information that we want to get from this zip code. And then we have our zip code database copied onto another tab in the worksheet. Now remember, we have over 42,000 rows of data here of zip codes in this database right here. So I wanted to show you a little trick. I'm not sure a lot of people or everyone knows about the data tab here on Excel. Normally when you're Excel, you're here on the home tab. But if you want to go over to the data tab, there's lots of different options here. The thing I use most often is this filter option here under the sort and filter menu. Now go ahead and highlight all of the header row of all the columns, go ahead and click on filter, and that gives you these little data filters, these little caret drop-down menus that when you click on them, you will see every single value, every single unique value in that column. Now let's go over here to the state column, for instance, here in column G. If you click on this, you can see all the different state abbreviations, and then Excel also gives you some different preset sorting options. So you could sort the column from A to Z, greatest to least, or Z to A in that descending order. So let's try Z to A and see what happens. When I click on that, there's all the Wyoming zip codes right here. It sorts the entire database for you. So if you're not using these data filters in your spreadsheets right now, I highly recommend that you use it. It's a great way to just sort of do some quick finding of certain values, or it's also another quick way to sort of validate your data to see what kinds of data, what values are popping up in this column. This is also a way that you can sort of do a quick search for any errors. So if I had a different database, and it was my own database, maybe I was entering some survey data or something like that, I could use these data filters to really look down the rows and make sure that all of the options that I have inside these cells are correct and there's no errors. So that's one way that you can sort of correct them. Another thing that you can use is the find tab. And if you've used Microsoft Word, you're probably familiar with find and replace. That same functionality exists in Excel and in PowerPoint. So go back up to the home tab and go all the way over here to the editing menu here, and then the find and select. And then you can go just here to find, and you could type in any value here and see what might pop up. So I typed in here 49423. I know that that's my zip code for Holland, Michigan, where I'm from. So let's see if that works. So I'm going to type in that value, and then I'm just going to click on find next. It'll take me right to the cell that it first populates with 49423, and you can see I can look across the row, and yes, it's from Holland, Michigan, Ottawa County. You can see this database also gives you information like latitude and longitude and the IRS estimated population for that zip code. So in my zip code of 49423 within Holland, Michigan, that estimated population is 41,000 people. Pretty interesting stuff. Okay, so I'm going to close out of this. And we're going to go back up to the top of the database just so we can start with the database that we had before. It doesn't matter how we're sorting, so you can leave it sorted as ever, you know, you can leave it sorted here as we sorted the Z to A with Wyoming first. Totally fine to do. Let's go back to our zip code list worksheet now, and now comes the fun part. This is where we're going to get our city, county, and state information directly from this zip code here, and then we're going to copy that all the way down the column so that we can get city, county, and state for every single zip code in our list. Okay, so when you create a function in Excel, you have to start with an equal sign. Anytime you're in a cell here, anything you type up here in the formula bar automatically goes into the cell here. So just know that these two things are connected right here. I'm going to go ahead and type equal, And the function that we're going to use is called XLOOKUP. Now, I have XLOOKUP because we're using Microsoft 365. If you do not have XLOOKUP in your version of Excel, go on to the next video. I'm going to do the exact same thing, but with a function that you do have access to called VLOOKUP or vertical lookup. So look to the next video if for some reason your version of Excel does not come yet with this XLOOKUP function. So I'm going to type in X. As soon as I type in X, Excel will give me this little drop-down box of any functions that start with the letter X. And I can see XLOOKUP right here. If you click on it, it also gives you a little blurb about what that function does. It says XLOOKUP searches a range or an array for a match and returns the corresponding item from a second range or array. Pretty cool stuff that Excel knows what I want to do. So I'm going to go ahead and double click on this, and it populates with the function that I want, equal XLOOKUP there. Every function has, once you type the function here, you have to start with an open parenthesis, and then we'll have to close it with a closed parenthesis once we're finished entering the values that we want to do. Excel is also telling me what I want to put, what do I want to put into this formula. The first value here is the lookup value. Where is the lookup value? I want that to be this zip code here, so I'm going to go ahead and click in the cell, and you can see up here it says, okay, B2 is the lookup value. Now I'm going to type a comma, and now it goes over to lookup array. Where is the lookup array, or what row or what range of cells do I want to look for this value in? And that's going to come from our zip code database. So while your cursor is still up here, go ahead and click on the zip code database tab. You can see that Excel is already telling me now, oh, you want to pull this range of cells from the zip code database tab. Yep. And then I'm going to go ahead and just click on the header column right here, A. This is my column of data that I want to pull or look up that zip code from. So I'm going to go ahead and click A. When I do that, you can see in the formula bar, it says, okay, zip code, column A. When you click on an entire column like that, it gives you this A:A value there. So that's how you know you put in the entire column, and that's what we want to do. Go ahead and type another comma. Now it says, what do you want to return? What's the return array? So it's going to look up a value, look up my value from that first tab. It's going to look at all of these zip codes. And what do I want it to return? I want it to return the city value. So I know that the city is in column D right here. So I'm going to go ahead and click on the column header there. And now it says zip code database from column D is going to be my return array. Perfect. Now I'm going to put in another comma. You have to put in one more piece of information. It's asking you to put in, what do you want it to return if for some reason they can't find the value? And in this case, I don't really have anything. I could just say, I could just type in quote. You have to open the quotes, and then I'll just say not found. But you could also just type two quotes, and that would return a space or something like that. There's two other things here, this match mode and the search mode. We don't need to use that for this purpose, so I'm just going to close my parenthesis now. And now I'm going to click enter, and when I click enter, it's going to take me back to my zip code list page, and the city from that first zip code in that first row should be there. Let's see what happens. I'm going to push enter now. All right, and you can see that it did that. It's now pulling the city of Battle Creek. It's saying that this zip code is from Battle Creek. Awesome. Now I'm going to do this exact same process for each of these other columns for county and state. So let's start again. Equal XLOOKUP, open parenthesis. I want it to look up value here in B2, comma. Go over to my zip code database. Here's my lookup array in column A, comma. What do I want it to return this time? County value. That's in column H. So I'm going to go ahead and click that. And then I'm going to push a comma. And then I'm going to open quotes and say not found. Close quotes. And then close my parenthesis. Push enter. And there's my county right there from this zip code. So it's saying that this zip code is Battle Creek, the city, Calhoun County, the county. Now let's do it one more time for state. Equals XLOOKUP. Open parenthesis, here's my lookup value there, comma, go over to my zip code database, I want it to be the, here's my lookup array in column A, comma, what value do I want it to return? I want it to return state values in column G, comma, open quote, not found, close quote, and now I'm going to close my parenthesis and push enter here. All right, so now I have a beautiful row here of city, county, and state all pulling from the single zip code using that Excel formula. Now, all I need to do, because Excel is responsive, it will, all I have to do is copy these cells down the column, and it will update based on this row here and this row here, all the subsequent rows it will update for. So let's try it just once and see what happens. I'm going to highlight these cells, right click to copy, click here, I'm going to right click to paste, and you can see it's different. It's not the exact same thing, because this row is looking up value B2 here in this cell. This cell here is looking up value B3 right here, and so on. So if I want to copy this down, I only have 30 zip codes, remember? So all I need to do is highlight the entire row that I want to copy, make sure that the cursor turns into this little plus sign here, and if I double click, it'll copy the formula down to the very last cell that has data in it until there's a space. Now, for 30 zip codes, I could probably just drag this down like this, but if you had a million zip codes, 10,000 zip codes, this double click option is going to work for you. So watch as I double click this. Once the mouse turns to this plus sign, I'm going to double click, and everything pops up. Perfect. Now I have a perfectly populated zip code lookup table here with city, county, and state information just from my single zip code there and our zip code database there. Now, in the next video, I'm going to do the exact same thing, but I'm going to use a different Excel function. It's going to be called VLOOKUP or vertical lookup. It involves a couple more clicks, but vertical lookup is available on all versions of Microsoft Excel, not just Microsoft 365. So if you're operating on an older version of Excel, you'll have access to VLOOKUP if you don't have access to XLOOKUP. So stay tuned to that next video, and if you don't need that next video, skip ahead to when we start summarizing some of this data using our pivot tables. If you like this video, make sure to give it a thumbs up and hit that subscribe button to get notified each time I post a new video on data viz, analysis, or presentation design using Excel and PowerPoint. You don't have to be a professional designer to look like one using the software you already have and know how to use. Thanks again for watching. I'll see you next time.